Do you know what that means? It's not technology. It's the T, the technology. This is education and the design. Did you know that? Do you thought it was the name of TED? It was. Or wasn't it? Who knows? It is, TED is here to inspire people to bring the passion up in all of us. Do we have passion? Somebody asked me today, do you think everybody has a passion? I think, yeah, I think everybody has a passion. It's gone sometimes. Very often it's gone. And with people that go to work every day, and all of you know, because I've said it for 10 years now, the sad little thing that most of the people don't like their work. And they go there every day. There are even people who have a contract on paper, and it says that you have to work from 8 till 5, and it shows an address where you have to be. You know those people? There are people that really have a contract that says, that tells them where they have to go in the morning. How sad can it be that you have a slavery document that tells you where to go, and all those people are standing in a traffic jam in the morning because they have to be in time for what? For nothing. For 70% of all the people in the Netherlands, in the world, but we are talking about the Netherlands here, it doesn't matter what time they are at their job. It doesn't matter if they are at their job at all for some people. And still they go. And when they are sitting behind a typewriter, we call it a computer, with their hands on the toetsenbord, and they look at the screen, their managers think they are working. How sad can it be? It makes me so mad. I've been talking about this for 10 years, 50 times a year, and still the score is 70% of the people don't like their jobs. What are you doing? Are you managers? Are you managing people? What the p are you doing? Fuck are you doing? I had a speech to give to HR managers, and I said, what a bunch of losers you are. Reporting to a financial director, allowing that you're not even in the board of management. Most HR people are not in the board, because in the mission statement it says, we value our people highly. That's the losers. We value our people highly. Don't believe that. We have people, we call them FTEs. You know that full-time equivalents. Somebody raised his hand in the audience lately and he said, I'm even a half of FTE. And it was a quarter FTE in the audience as well. How sad can we be? So that has to change, dare to change. And because it is so difficult, I took this picture for all of you. It took me months to make. Because it only happens once a year, as you can imagine. And you never know where. This was in Scotland. Passion, where did it go? Sometimes I have to make a presentation, I have slides, and I will show you the slides that you probably will wonder during my talk what the slides are all about. Now, about nothing. To entertain you a little bit, because I never know in the beginning what I'm going to talk. I'm going to talk about what I feel, and I should talk about passion, and how can we bring that back? Because if we lose the people, we don't even have to talk about sustainability. We forget it, because it's logical. It is there anyway. People show up in the mornings anyway. 50% of all the people don't even have energy in the morning, like me. They also have to be there. They sleep at their desk. In the past, we even had clocks at the door. And people walked into their offices and they took a piece of paper, put it in the clock, and the clock said, ping, and people were immediately at work. They call it a prick clock. Americans always ask me, well, is that a prick clock? A prick clock? It's a clock for pricks. But still, there are companies who have prick clocks. I tell you, I promise you, there are companies that have those clocks on the wall. And there are many people who don't need those clocks because they have them in their head. Because that's how we are raised, by our parents, by our companies. And that is actually something that we have to change. That was me, I was doing a... I was walking in the mountains. Long time ago, I'm the right guy with the long hair. You think it's a girl, but it's me. And it's when I was young, we have a rope around us. My father had a dream, a passion. He wanted to walk in the mountains. Every vacation, we had to go to Switzerland. There are horrible mountains in Switzerland, I can tell you that. They go up and down and up and down. They're very high. And he had children, like young children, four. We wanted to swim, play football with friends. No, every morning at 6:30, he was standing there with big rucksacks and ropes. And he said, we go into the mountains, hiking. We hated the mountains. I still hate the mountains. I'm so happy with the Netherlands. We only have one little mountain in the south, 500 meters. Already horrible. But it is. But this was his dream, his passion. When he was 53, he quit his job from one day to the other. And he said, I'm going to hike in the mountains. I thought he was crazy. He wanted to become a mountain guide. I was studying to become an accountant. Well, that is also who was more crazy, you can wonder. Me, to become an accountant, which I became for only 1 year. And my father, who wanted to become a mountain guide. I thought, what does it look like of your resume when you show your resume and it says mountain guide? You cannot find a job at Shell, KLM, Schiphol Group, or whatever. Maybe a Schiphol Group, if I look at this space here. You can become a mountain guide, but nowhere else. So I thought he was crazy. Later on, I started to admire him, because who of you dares to do that? I'll give you a little exercise. When you go home tonight, in the car, in the train, in the plane, on the bicycle, think about the following question. Do I like what I do? Is this fun? Is it fun? You ask it to yourself, not to anybody else, because then you're going to lie for sure. But you ask it to yourself, and then the only answer is an honest answer. You can say yes, that is good. And if it's no, you say no. And that is actually not so good, but it is at least honest if you say no. Now, I've been there today, maybe this Friday was nice, but for the rest, I hate it. Then on Monday, you do something about it. You go to your manager and say, I've thought about it the whole weekend and start on Friday evening, and I must tell you, I hate what I do. Also hate you, but and the environment and everything here. So I just wanted to let you know, and now I'm going on with my work. And then you walk out of her office. If you dare to do that, can you imagine what a happy day this Monday will be? If you dare to do that. If you dare to say that. I gave a speech about half a year ago to 250 high potentials of the Ministry of Economic Affairs. High potential, 250? Yeah. Potentials also, and maybe low potentials, but a whole room full of all kinds of potentials. And I said this, if you don't like it, stand up and go. So in the middle of the speech, a woman stood up. She stood up and I said, is something wrong? And she said, yeah, I'm going. I've always hated it here, I leave. And she walked out. What a successful speech that was. Eh? That finally, I touched somebody. And the director of the ministry was sitting there and I said, do you want me to continue? Or he was not afraid to have an empty room at the end of the speech. So he said, please continue. But somebody who dares to do that. I gave another speech to the NS. NS means, as you know, the Dutch Railroad, for a smaller group, 15 high potentials. It's already a lot for the NS, but anyway. And I asked them to do a little exercise. And the little exercise was to, what do you do when you're fired from one moment to another? They don't give you any money, and the government doesn't give you any money either. So you have no money from the one moment to the other. That happens in America quite often, but in Holland it's impossible. So I thought, what will you do then? What do you do when that happens? So all of them gave a speech, and one of them was extremely good. And I went to the guy, it was a guy in this case, a man and woman, of course, and I said to him, why don't you do that? What you just said. Why don't you activate that idea? It's a great idea. And he said, well, because my boss doesn't want that. That's what he said. Yeah, you're astonished as well. I see it's silent, you're horrified. My boss, he said that, my boss, my boss. I said, you're not a dog. Are you a dog? He looked like a human being, but are you a dog? A dog has a boss, eh? And he said, no, I said, you don't have a boss. Nobody has a boss. You are your own. Please, come on. Don't live up to this contract of 40 hours behind your typewriter or whatever, or your prick clock. So, are you good? I asked him, you're a high potential. Are you good? How good are you? Are you better than all the others in this audience? He said, well, you know, are you the best in this audience? Oh, that is not a good answer. He said, I think I am. It's typically non-Dutch. Normally a Dutch person says, I like it. What's your name?
Marcel.
Marcel says I am. Normally people say, no, for sure I'm not. But when people say in the Netherlands, people say, yes, I'm the best for sure. Everybody looks, oh yeah, no, we know him, yeah. He always sits on the front row, like there, Marcel. And he is, why wouldn't he sit there? Eh? He's the best. So this guy said, I'm one of the best of the 15. Said, so I'm talking to the guy at the NS who is one of the top potentials and one of the best of them. And you have an idea and you don't do it because you're boss. Said, just do it. Said, I might be fired. I said, and that is great news because then you finally get rid of your boss if you're fired. Well, he started his own company. And that is, I'm going through my time. Why are you here? That is the question. That's the most important question. You don't talk about the fate of the world or sustainability or what I was talking about before this presentation was these big advertisements that you see in the newspapers now about the race to the green conquest or the green quest or something like that. And you see companies and they talk about sustainability, and it was about ABN AMRO Bank and what they're doing to separate the waste, and they have LED lights and electrical cars. What a nonsense that is. Do you think it's nonsense? Of course it's nonsense. It's hygiene. That is hygiene. We do that anyway. We always separate our waste. We always have LED lights. We always have electrical cars. So what do we do? What is here with the ABN AMRO Bank? In this case, it's ABN AMRO Bank. It's the money. What do we do with the money? It's the core business. If you want to be sustainable, it is here and not there. It is your passion. It is why are you here? Why are you a bank? Are you a bank to have to separate your waste? No. What is the core of your business? And that has to be sustainable. And not because somebody else tells you, but because you feel it. It has to be authentic, because otherwise nobody will believe you. Because people feel immediately if I'm standing here and lying to you or not. And your employees feel that immediately. Why are you here? Because you want to have a value, of course. I will click through the presentation. I'm not going to say anything about this because I have no time. Tony Schiocoloni, those are feel good. This is what do you feel? If you talk about something, what do you feel? That is important about companies. If you walk into an office, you work for a company, there's somebody from Microsoft here. Who is that? Oh, Marcel. Yeah. Sure, it's Marcel again. Hey. It's, we didn't practice this, eh? But next time you can go with me when I do a speech. And we do this. Microsoft, I saw it on the list, because Microsoft is somewhere here over there, I believe. And I pick Microsoft because if you walk into that office, they have done their best, and I think fairly well succeeded. that you feel something. Many offices, when you walk into their building, you walk into the building, you have to ask yourself, do I feel anything at all? Anything at all? No. Most companies, you don't feel anything. And then they have workshops and out-of-the-box sessions and high sessions and whatever to do to see how can we make a connection to our customer to make them feel something. Well, Google, slowly but certainly, is going in the wrong direction, you all know, because we are thinking it's not a good company, it's an evil company. Well, that is, mark my words, 4 or 5 years from now, big discussions with Google. And it started as a company who didn't want any evil. So, and they have very nice colors, as you can see, very nice logo. Be creative, we talked about it, I'm not going to talk about it, I have no time. Happy companies, because I want to say something about sparkling and about how you can do that. And a little action list for you to take home. Sparkling is the most important word for any company. Sparkling means that you have to feel something, that you have to have fun, and it is free, because you do it yourself. It's free. It means that you feel something when you go into a company and that you're not an FTE, but that you are a person. So, does any one of you ever have a meeting? Meetings? Meetings, no. No, I hope not. And then you even have, sometimes you have meetings, tell you a little secret, and they have minutes of meetings. That's very old-fashioned, I know, so most of you are too young to have ever heard about that, but people make minutes because there are people who are not there. What a bloody shame. Eh? Open up all the meetings to everybody. There are companies in the world who have done that, they open up other, every meeting is open to everybody. You think, oh, there will be the busy meetings. No, nobody will show up anymore. People only go to meetings that they like. So finally we have meetings with people who are there with for a reason and not because they have to be and they have to read the minutes, etc. Action. One thing. You all have seen, to be quick now, oh, 29, 28. Now I'm going to finish this anyway because it's only a minute. This is a business card. You all have seen that maybe once in your life. And on the front side of the business card, there is a name, an email address. We call that the FTE side of the business card. I've always asked in my companies to people to put on the back of their business card 4 words. You can do that. You can take that to your own organization. Or you can even write it with your pen. The 4 words that mean the most to you, individual people. And then you show your business card to people. And you show it upside down. And people will say, what is that? And then you can say, that is me. Thank you.